Kan du afsnit noget her? Jeg tager på det sjakul, og hvad er det, der valgt?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, curmudgeons and old hags, everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to make panoramas. Now, making panoramas used to be incredibly finicky and tiring, requiring the technical know-how of the Borg and the patience of a saint. But all of that's changed now, thanks to a piece of software called the Microsoft Image Composite Editor, or Microsoft ICE for short, or if you want really short, MICE. I'm going to show you how to use it today, but first you can download it for free. Follow the link in the show notes, download it from there, and for the rest of the tutorial I'm going to show you how to use it. So let's get to it. Okay, so here it is. Here's the Microsoft Image Composition Editor. This is what it looks like when you start it up. So let's go and create a panorama. I took some shots from Wellington earlier. That's where I'm living at the moment. So I select them. I just drag and drop them onto this gray area here. And the software is going to go away and create a preview for me. And it's usually pretty quick at doing that. There we go. Okay, so the software is amazingly good at picking the projection and picking all the settings automatically. The only thing you usually have to do is to do some cropping. You can do that by just dragging these borders to contain the part of the image that you want. Most of the time, all you want to do is just get rid of this jagged edge that goes up here along the edge. To do that automatically, just click this automatic crop button, and it's going to pick the biggest panorama that you can get, excluding the jagged edges. I'm going to just get rid of this flagpole here. I don't like it. And move that up a little bit there. That's looking good. So click export to disk. Choose where you want your image to be exported and click save. And then MICE is going to go away. It's going to pick 100 little merge points. It's going to do color correction for you. It's going to do blending. Going to do exposure fixing, all of that stuff that takes absolutely ages to do manually. Trust me, I know, I used to do this in Photoshop. So there, it's done, super quick. There's my new image. Double click it to open it up, and here it is, an absolute beauty, done in less than a minute. That's it. That's how quick and easy it is to make a panorama. So you're probably thinking that a drag and drop and two mouse buttons clicks isn't that much of a tutorial, and I would agree. So let's do something a bit more interesting. Let me show some of the more advanced settings. This is a 360 degree panorama I took earlier today. So I'm gonna drag all of those photos over. No, I don't want to save that project. And mine's gonna go away and create the preview for me. So the thing with 360 degree panoramas is that the software has no way of knowing where the center of the panorama is, because there isn't a center. It's a 360 degree circle around the photographer. So it's just going to pick a center point on random, but you might not like what it picks, and I'm going to show you how you can pick your own center point for the panorama. Any moment now. There we go. Okay, so all I do is click this edit button up here. Takes me to the edit screen. So like I said before, the software is usually really good at getting the merging done properly the first time around. But sometimes it gets it wrong. Sometimes the horizon is a little bit off. It's not completely level. And you can change that by just dragging the horizon up and down like this. Sometimes the image is a bit askew. You might want to rotate it like this. Or maybe you just like a wavy world. It's fine. It's your world. Do whatever you want with it. Me, I kind of like a nice flat world. So I'm going to click revert. Get rid of those changes. Because all I really wanted to do was just pick the midpoint. To do that, just drag it along horizontally like this. So maybe I like the center to be the sun. That's the center of my universe. No, no. It's not just factually incorrect. It kind of looks a bit silly. So I'm going to drag it over there. That looks good. I like that arc there. That makes me happy. So I'm going to click apply. It's going to go away and create the preview again. So to take this shot, I had to walk out at Lowry Bay out on a windswept cliff, almost blew me off into the bay, almost died taking this photo. The things I do for you. That's all right, you're totally worth it. Hope your day was fine. My day was okay. Near-death experience, always spices things up. Right, there we go, it's done. Automatic crop. I should have said that you can pick the image output format. I'm happy with JPEG. But 13,800 pixels wide, that's a bit rich. So I'm gonna scale that down to 4,000. And click export the disk. Save where I want it. Click save. And it's gonna go away and create a panorama for me. I'm not gonna wait for this, I'm gonna fast forward. And there we go. Done. So let me go and have a look at the finished product. Look at that beauty. Isn't that gorgeous? That is how simple it is to make one of these panoramas, but don't tell anyone. Certainly don't make a blog post about it. You want to be able to tell that you've been slaving over this wonderful image for hours and hours and hours. Speaking of blog posts, if you came from YouTube, you might want to click on the link in the show notes. That'll take you to the blog post I wrote about panorama images. There you'll also find out different tips on how to take the shots that goes into the panorama, just as important, if not more. And that is pretty much all I had to say. That concludes my tutorial on Microsoft Ice. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please share it with your dog, your nan, whoever you want to share it with, maybe Facebook. And thank you for watching. Be brave and live free.